Good afternoon, everybody. My name is M. Jhansi Lakshmi. I am working as an assistant professor in SNH department as a mathematics faculty. Today, I am going to explain the topic of linear partial differential equation of first order, that is linear partial differential equations of first order. Linear means the differential, partial differential equation which is having the degree as 1 is linear. First order means an equation involving the only first order derivative, that is first order derivative, is called linear partial differential equation of first order, which is in this form. We have one equation PP plus QQ is equal to R. PP plus QQ is equal to R, where P and E, comma Q and R are the functions of X, Y, Z. Then this equation is also called Lagrange's partial differential equation of first order first degree. Lagrange's partial differential equation of first order and first degree. For this equation, we have to take first subsidiary equations. Subsidiary equations we have to take, that are dx by p is equal to dy by q is equal to dz by r. We know that p, q, r are the functions of x, y, z. Solving this type of equations, we have two methods. Which equations means? With the equation which is in the form of PP plus QQ is equal to R, to solve this equation, which is Lagrange's partial differential equation, we have two methods. The first method is method of grouping. First one is method of grouping. Method of grouping. Second one is method of multipliers. Method of multipliers. Method of grouping and method of multipliers. What is method of grouping? By the subsidiary equations, we have to take any two relations like dx by p is equal to dy by q and dx by q is dy by q is equal to dz by r. Any two relations, not only compulsory these two, you may take dx by p is equal to dy by q and dx by p is equal to dz by r. Otherwise, these two relations you can take. By taking these two relations, we have to solve by applying suitable integral formula. After that, we have to take integrating on both sides. We'll get the solution of two independent equations. The solution, that is pi of u comma v is equal to 0. Pi of u comma v is equal to 0, where u is a function of v defined. So this is a method of solving linear partial differential equation of first order. So we will do one problem, which is of the form PP plus QQ is equal to R. Example, I will take P plus Q is equal to 1. P plus Q is equal to 1. We know that where P, small p, is a first order derivative, which is nothing but dou z by dou x. Q is equal to dou z by dou y. P is equal to dou z by dou x. Q is equal to dou z by dou y. Then this is, by seeing this, we can understand this equation is linear partial differential equation of first order and first degree. The order is 1 here, degree of the differential equation is also 1. So by seeing this equation, we can understand this equation is of the form PP plus QQ is equal to R, where capital P is equal to 1, Q is equal to also 1, and which is R is equal to also 1. Because of PP plus QQ is equal to R, here P is equal to 1, Q is equal to also 1 and R is equal to also 1. So we have to solve this equation by applying any one of the method, or sometimes we can apply to find the one solution for grouping method, one solution by using the multipliers method. So here first we have to take the subsidiary equations or auxiliary equations. Subsidiary equations are, we know dx by 3 is equal to dy by 2 is equal to dz by r, where capital P is equal to 1, Q is equal to 1, R is equal to 1. Substituting in subsidiary equations, we have here dx by P means dx by 1 is equal to dy by 1 is equal to dz by 1. Okay. From here we have to take any two relations. Shall we take here, let dx by 1 is equal to dy by 1. Shall we take here by cross multiplication, dx is equal to dy. Dx is equal to dy. Integrating on both sides, integral dx is equal to integral dy plus, shall I take the constant as c1. After every integration, we have to take the arbitrary constant, that is c1 here. So integral dx is nothing but x, integral dy is equal to y plus c1. Shall we take here x of x minus y is equal to c1, which is nothing but u of x comma y function this is. So we have to find the second solution for this. Shall we take this relation over by taking dx by 1 is equal to dy by 1? Shall we take in the second step here dy by 1 is equal to dz by 1. Dy by 1 is equal to dz by 1. From here we have to take again cross multiplication, dy is equal to dz. Integrating on both sides, the integral dy is equal to integral dz plus c2. So we know this integral dy is y, integral dz is z plus c2. Shall we take y minus z is equal to c2? Suppose this is u of x comma y function, this is v of y comma z function, then the final solution of this partial differential equation is pi of u comma v is equal to 0. That is pi of, what is u here? U is nothing but x minus y, v is nothing but y minus z, which is equal to 0. This is the required solution of a partial differential equation p plus q is equal to r, which is first order equation. This method is applying grouping method. We solved this problem using grouping method. Shall we take another question? That is the question, second one I am taking here. That is x into y minus z into p plus y into z minus x into q is equal to z into x minus y. By seeing this equation, we know this equation is in the form of pp plus qq is equal to r. pp plus qq is equal to r. Means which is Lagrange's partial differential equation of first order. Partial differential equation of first order. So comparing this with the form, we know here capital P is a function of x, y, z, that is x into y minus z. Capital Q is equal to y into z minus x. With Q is there, that function is comparing with capital Q. R is equal to z into x minus y. R is equal to z into x minus y. Shall we take the first step of solving this? Subsidiary equations. Subsidiary equations are, we know dx by p is equal to dy by q is equal to dz by r. Shall we substitute p, q, r functions here? That is, what is p here? X into y minus z. X into y minus z. Q is nothing but y into z minus x. R is nothing but z into x minus y. So shall we take here, grouping method is not applicable here because of we are getting here the term z, but there is no dz here. So for that purpose, we can't apply for this problem group method of grouping. For that purpose, we have to take the method of multipliers. Method of multipliers I want to take. Method of multipliers is nothing but we have to choose the multipliers n, m, n multipliers which are not only constants. We may get sometimes functions or sometimes constants depending on the p, q, z. We have to choose these multipliers. Here l, m, l, m, n are called the multipliers. Choose the multipliers such that LBX, LB plus MQ plus NR is equal to 0. LP plus MQ plus NR is equal to 0. Such that we have to choose the multipliers here. Suppose if I take here DX by X into Y minus Z is equal to DY by Y into Z minus X is equal to DZ by Z into X minus Y. See here, LP plus MQ plus NR is equal to 0. Shall we take here L is equal to 1, M is equal to 1, and N is equal to also 1. L is equal to 1, M is equal to 1, N is equal to 1. Suppose L is equal to 1, means 1 into this. See here, 1 into X into Y minus Z plus 1 into Y into Z minus X plus 1 into Z into X minus Y must be equal to 0. This we are getting here 0 plus XY. Here minus XY gets cancelled. Minus XZ here plus XZ. So all the terms are getting cancelled. Therefore we can choose for the first solution that multipliers as 1, 1, 1. That means LP plus MQ plus LP plus MQ plus NR is equal to, we are getting 0. Therefore, in the numerator also we have to take as a multipliers 1, 1, 1. That means 1 into DX plus 1 into DY plus 1 into DZ by, here this is getting 0. Therefore, 1 into X into Y minus Z plus 1 into Y into Z minus X plus 1 into Z into X minus Y is equal to also 0. Therefore, let dx plus dy plus dz is equal to 0. Integrating on both sides, integral dx plus integral dy plus integral dz is equal to 0. Sorry, after integration we have to take as a constant, that is first constant I am taking as a c1. Integral dx is x, integral dy is y, integral dz is equal to z, which is equal to c1. We have the first solution, that is u of x comma y comma, that is equal to this one. We have to find the second solution also by using the method. Again, grouping is not applicable here. So we have to use the multipliers method. Choose the second multipliers. Shall we take here multipliers as, again the condition is LP plus MQ plus NR is equal to 0. For example, if we'll take 1 by x as a multiplier, x in 1 by x into x, these two gets cancelled, remaining is 1 minus z. Similarly, y by cancel, z minus x. Similarly, 1 by z into z by cancel, x minus y. It becomes a 0. So, we have to take here L as a 1 by x, M as a 1 by y, N as a 1 by z are the multipliers here. So, shall we take for suppose that, see here, 1 by x into p, what is p here? X into y minus z plus 1 by y into, that is y into z minus x plus 1 by z into x minus y, which is equal to getting as a 0. Therefore, we have to take here the multipliers as 1 by x, 1 by y, 1 by z. 1 by x into dx plus 1 by y into dy plus 1 by z into dz. 0. Integrating on both sides, integral 1 by x dx plus integral 1 by y dy plus integral 1 by z dz is equal to shall I take here log C2 as an arbitrary constant? Log X plus log Y plus log Z is equal to log C2. Integral 1 by X dx is log X. Integral 1 by Y dy is log Y. Integral 1 by Z dz is log Z, which is equal to log C2. So we know that removing log on both sides, which gives us x, y, z is equal to c2. The general solution of this is, first solution is x plus y plus z and is equal to c1. Second solution is nothing but x, y, z is equal to c2. Writing together these two solutions, the first solution is x plus y plus z, second solution is x, y, z, which gives us the final solution of the linear partial differential equations of first order.